underneath the lovely London sky.
Everyone, welcome to this vlog. I'm in my mum's room because everyone's home because Michael still hasn't gone to university yet. We are starting this video of me looking like this, really tired because I don't go to bed when I'm supposed to. But I'm just about to get ready for my inductions for my master's course, and when I'm ready, I'll talk to you a bit more about the things on my mind because my mum is just there looking at me. This is really awkward. Hello. So basically, today is, you can hear my mum talking on the phone upstairs. Today is the first day of inductions for my course, and I thought instead of doing a sit-down video, because I wanted to do a sit-down video about going back to uni with it being online, and I just didn't know quite what to say, and I tried to film it a few times, and I just felt it was really awkward and weird. So what I decided to do was I would vlog my first day and talk about going back with things being half online and stuff like that, and talk about some of the issues that some students are facing with their universities and halls and stuff. It's about 12 o'clock now. I'm gonna go and get some lunch, and then it will be the start of my inductions for this week. I have inductions Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, I think. And then I have one day in campus next week. Fingers crossed we can still do that. Who knows if we'll actually be able to do that, but fingers crossed we'll be able to do it. And I'll definitely vlog on that day when I go down to London. I'm still deciding whether I'm going to get up super early and get on the train that morning, or whether I'm going to see if I can stay at a friend's house in London. But I just don't feel comfortable asking to stay at someone's house during a pandemic, you know? So maybe I'll just have to have a really early morning. When I move, me and Adam are planning to move to Coventry very, 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 very soon. Very, very soon. When that happens, I won't have such a big commute. It'll be, the train journey will only be an hour, 20 minutes, something like that. So it'll be a lot less of a journey than it is from here in the Northwest. So yeah, I'm very excited for this day to start. I'm very excited for this course to start. First of all, it's just really exciting because as a kid, I've talked about this before, but as a kid, I always wanted to go to drama school. And then I decided that, I decided within myself that I didn't think I was good enough to do it. So then I went down the academic route and I enjoyed my time at ECL. It was very good and I loved the academic experience of, you know, doing an academic subject. I loved it, but my heart is in drama. And when I found this course, it was just really nice. And then my imposter syndrome creeped in and again, and it was like, you're not good enough, they're not gonna like you, they're not gonna give you an offer. And then when they did give me an offer, it was like, well, you're not gonna meet it, are you? But here I am, going to drama school. Like, what the hell? What the hell? This is so exciting. I'm gonna give you a little bit of an outfit of the day because I just feel like it. But here we go. So I have this dress, which is just like a basic t-shirt dress that is kind of like, you know, just above the knee. And this is from, I think my mum got it from ASOS, Boohoo? Not sure. Should I check the tag? Yes, this is from Boohoo if anyone is interested. And I've done my makeup today. I've done a little light face makeup. And I tried to do some like wacko eyeshadow. It didn't go very well. Sat on the floor of my mum's bedroom like, why is this not looking so great? So I just decided to put glitter and call it a day, and some lip gloss, and I'm just really excited. I'm just really excited, guys. Guys, just got a piece of mail. I'm gonna cover up my address, but it's from Royal Central School of Speech and Drama. I think that it is my ID card. So this is all very, very exciting. Okay, so, oh, I can't even open it. It's very secure. Jesus. This is so exciting. So they gave us this little thing, which is like a door handle pusher knob thing. I don't know why I just said the word knob, but oh my god, look at it. That is me. Wow, this is so cute. They gave us a little coronavirus in London leaflet and the lanyard. I'm so excited, guys. It was just like an introduction to the people session. It wasn't really a course induction. We have that next week. But it was just getting to know the class a little bit. It was very nice answering a few questions if anyone had any burning questions. And then there's a few more events this week, sessions that are like from the school, not particularly for the course. So we have a postgraduate welcome and an induction for COVID and a how to central. But it's all starting, and it's very, very exciting. Currently, I'm on hold with Virgin. Basically, because that is so loud. basically, because I tried to get them to send me information to transfer the Wi-Fi over to the new tenants of the flat that I moved out of, and they just didn't send it to me. And then I had them post it to my old address, but then the letter went missing. So that's what's happening. The first session that we just did was so much fun. It was just really nice to slip back into normality, you know, a little bit. And then we have one more session in about 20 minutes. So I hope, fingers crossed, that I can talk to Virgin before then, but if not, that's okay. So I'm gonna go in the kitchen and get a snickety snack. Yeah, that's what's happening. It's been a nice, nice day for me with my course. Mom is making, hold on.
Ashley, out of the kitchen.
I sneezed into my elbow.
It doesn't matter, I don't want you in the kitchen.
She's making pasta shells. Look at the pasta shells! And cannelloni!
Right, out of the kitchen and go wash your arm.
So here I am again, unboxing something. So basically, I ordered some little stationery items from Paper Chase the other day. And here they are. Here we go. So I have some colourful gel pens, some black pens with little erasers, and three exercise books that look like this because I needed something to write with and write on for my course, and these look like a good option. So that is what I got. I have another package. This is one of the coursework, the course texts that we're supposed to read. And this one is called The Politics of Performance, Radical Theatre as Cultural Intervention, Baz Kershaw. Oh, shall I smell it? See what it smells like? Oh, it smells quite nice. That's what it looks like. Currently in a library induction. I'm vlogging in class, guys. This is really weird. Guys, I want to say a big thank you to my friend Hannah for reminding me that the Hebrew and Jewish Studies party and prize giving is happening now. And the reason why this is so exciting is because I'm getting a prize. They're giving me a prize. It's called the Harris Prize, if you ever want to look it up. And it's a prize from the Hebrew and Jewish Studies. So this is very exciting. I'm very excited. I'm just going to go and get the prize.
Prize. A prize that will very kindly donate to the participants by Emma Harris, who is their here today. Hello, Emma. Used to be administrator in our department for very many years, and then she went to Cambridge, where she's now at the Wood Centre. In our department, Emma made an extremely generous move, which was to donate this prize. And this year, we are very glad to award it to a student who has just finished a BA in Ancient Languages. Ashley Haywood. Oh, is it? You're here, Ashley, yeah? Yeah.
Yay! Well done, Ashley.
Many congratulations.
Thank you. Oh, everyone has frozen. Very annoyingly, my Wi-Fi cut out just when the woman who, as you saw, Emma Harris, who put up the money for the prize, was talking about the prize, congratulating me, and I'm really annoyed about that, but can't do anything about that. But I'm just really sad. One of my best friends from my course is staying on to do an MA in the department, and it's just, she couldn't be there without me. I've said this a lot. I was talking to Adam about it today, that I'm really sad that I'm not still at UCL, but I feel guilty about it because I've got a new exciting adventure ahead of me at Central, and I'm still in the University of London family of universities. I can still visit UCL, and it's not like UCL is now barred to me, but it's really sad. That's what's happening right now. I think I'm going to go and wash my hair, because I haven't washed it in a few days. So I think this is going to be the end of the vlog. I vlogged for 2 days this week, just because I thought the one vlog, just yesterday's vlog, it wasn't substantial enough. Like, I was starting to edit it, and it just didn't feel good enough. So I decided to vlog a little bit today as well. So I hope you enjoyed it. Next week, when I go to campus, I will be vlogging the first day when I go to campus. Obviously not in classes, but the whole experience of commuting down there and getting to the school and maybe a little bit around the school and stuff like that. So I will be doing that, and so I'm very, very excited that I have my new journey. And that was really nice to have a little bit of closure today of UCL. So peace out, guys. Thanks for being a faithful, and thanks for watching. Mwah.